हेलो माय डियर फ्रेंड्स एंड स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल। इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव डिस्कस सम ऑफ द शॉर्टकट कीज फॉर द एक्सेल। नाउ आई एम बैक विद वन मोर वीडियो व्हिच इज द पार्ट टू ऑफ बेसिक एक्सेल ट्रेनिंग फॉर बिगिनर्स। आई होप यू ऑल हैव वॉच्ड माय प्रीवियस वीडियो व्हिच इज द पार्ट वन ऑफ द बेसिक एक्सेल ट्रेनिंग। सो इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू मोर शॉर्टकट कीज व्हिच आर वेरी यूजफुल for the day-to-day routine Excel work. So let us start with Control G and let us see how it works. Okay, so I've pressed together Control G and my cell of reference is A25. It means I want to go to the cell A25, so I am clicking OK. As you can see, I have reached the cell A25. Let us do it again, Control G, and as you can see, previously we have done A25, so it will appear here. Now I'll try for B23 and I'll click on OK. So as you can see, we have reached the cell B23. Now we'll see for Control plus K, which functions as inserting the hyperlink. For this, let me open a new workbook. So this is my new Excel workbook and I have already entered the data. Open 1, open 2, open 3. So what is inserting hyperlink? When we'll click on open 1, we want it to open some pages or some documents. So let us try. I'll first select open 1 and I'll do Control K. So you can go to the any folder or browse pages or some recent files whenever you will click open 1. So I'm selecting here custom office template and I'm selecting here capture and I'm clicking here OK. So you have inserted the hyperlink. So in this way it will open. So again I'll show you, if you want to go, so in this way you can open it. Okay, now we'll go to our next shortcut key, which is Control N. Control N will give you a new workbook. So let me press together Control N. So as you can see, a new workbook will get open in this way. Next is Control P. So let us do Control P and see. So here it is, your print option. You can select the number of copies from here and the orientation from here. If you want portrait orientation, you can select portrait. If you want landscape, you can select landscape. So like this it will come, and you can select the paper sizes as letter or A4. Usually we use A4. And you can select the margins as well. If you want the margins to be wide, normal or narrow, you can use accordingly. And you can click on the print button to print it. Now let us see the shortcut keys Control Y and Control Z. So basically, if Control Z is for undo, Control Y is for redo. So you can redo or undo the things. Next we'll go for the function keys from F1 to F12. F1 is for any help regarding Excel. So as you can see on the right side, I'll again show you. F1 is for the help. If you have any problem regarding Excel formulas, functions or formatting the data or getting started with Excel, then you can do F1 and you can find out your solution. Next is F2. This is also somewhere useful. So if you want to edit a cell without deleting the data, then you can go and press F2 and then you can start editing this way. So this is the way how F2 works, because if you go and suddenly start editing, then the previous data will go. If you don't want that thing to happen, then you can just do F2. F3 is not much in use. F4 is for repeating the last action. So it is somewhat like redo and undo. One more use of F4 is while typing a formula, you can switch between the relative or absolute references. F5 is for go to. We are using Ctrl G for the same purpose. F7 I have told about. F7 is for the spelling check, and F6 is not much in use. F8, F9, F10 is not much in use. F11 is for the new chart. If you are preparing some chart, then if you want new chart, then you can press F11. F12 is saving your document under some name. Now we'll see some more shortcut keys, which are Ctrl plus this symbol. So you can find this symbol easily in your keyboard. If you want to insert the current time, so I am doing Ctrl and Shift colon. So as you can see, they have entered the current time, right? So this is the current time now. Let me close this. So in this way you can insert the current time. If you want to insert the current date, then Ctrl and press the symbol. You can see the current date will appear, right? Next is Ctrl plus double inverted comma. So this is to copy value from the cell above. So let me try to the cell. Ctrl and inverted comma. So as you can see, it has changed to none, which was in the cell above. Next is copy formula from cell above. You can use Ctrl and single inverted comma. Next is Shift. Shift is for holding down for additional functions in Excel's menu. We shall see this in our part 3. And there are some more Shift plus function keys which you can use, and these are somewhat repetitive for whatever shortcut keys we have seen above. So that's all. There are some more keys and there are some description. You can go through the description box. I'll put the link for this training material, so don't worry about it. Also, if you have any doubt regarding the shortcut keys performance, then please do comment on the comment section and let me know. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you find this video helpful, then please do like and share this video. Also, subscribe to our channel to keep watching more videos like this. We will be back with one more video, which is the part 3 of basic Excel training soon. Till then, take care of yourself. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.